Hello guys, it's me, Sir Dan Apostol. Welcome back to our channel. So in this video, we are going to discuss on how to simplify fraction or reduce the fractions in lowest term. So kailangan lang natin makuha yung lowest term. So by using or getting the GCF or greatest common factor. So, kailangan lang natin makuha yung GCF para ma-simplify natin yung mga fractions. So, let's have this example number 1. So, number 1, 3 over 6. So, para makuha natin yung GCF, ang technique na ituturo ko is hindi yung usual way, which is by getting the factors of numerator and denominator. So, ang gagawin lang natin is to look at the denominator. If the denominator is divisible to the numerator, divisible ba yung 6 sa 3? Pag sinabing divisible, ibig sabihin, ang kanilang quotient ay whole number. So, kung whole number, like this one, 6 divided by 3, that is 2. Therefore, yung pinakamaliit na number doon sa fraction na yon, which is 3, that is the GCF. So, ang GCF natin dito ay 3. So, yung GCF, para ma-simplify natin itong fraction na to, i-divide lang natin siya both numerator and denominator. So, 3 divided by 3, that is 1, and 6 divided by 3, that is 2. Therefore, the simplified form of 3 over 6 is 1/2. Okay, next, number 2. So, we have 8 over 12. So, the same process lang para makuha natin yung GCF. So, ang gagawin lang natin is tignan natin yung denominator if divisible ba siya sa numerator natin. Yung 12 ba ay divisible sa 8? So, hindi. Therefore, meron tayong next step na gagawin pag hindi siya divisible. Ang next step is to subtract the denominator, which is 12, sa ating numerator, which is 8. So, 12 minus 8 is 4. Now, yung ating nakuhang sagot, divisible na ba yung numerator and denominator? So, divisible na siya, meaning yung 4, that is our GCF. Then again, divide natin both numerator and denominator by 4. So, that is 8 divided by 4, we have 2. 12 divided by 4, we have 3. So, the simplified form of 8 over 12 is 2/3. Okay, next number 3. So, 10 over 35. The same process, first step, if divisible ba yung denominator sa numerator natin? So, again, hindi. Ang next step ay susundin natin, which is, isusubtract natin yung 35 sa 10. Or yung 10, isusubtract natin sa 35. So, ang magiging sagot natin ay 25. Now, yung 25 ba? Ay yung divisible na ba yung 10 and 35 sa 25? So, hindi pa rin. Kung hindi siya divisible, meron pa tayong gagawin na next step, which is the third step. Kukunin lang natin yung factors netong 25. So, that is 5 times 5. Now, titingin tayo sa factors na yon kung alin yung divisible yung 35 and 10. Since parehas naman silang 5, therefore, ang ating GCF ay 5. Kasi divisible na yung 35 and 10 sa 5. Then, divide natin both numerator and denominator by 5. So, 10 divided by 5, we have 2. 35 divided by 5, we have 7. So, the simplified form of 10 over 35 is 2 over 7. Next, number 4. So, 35 over 45. Tignan natin kung divisible yung 45 sa 35. So, hindi siya whole number. Therefore, gagawin natin yung next step, which is 45 minus 35. So, magiging sagot natin ay 10. Then, yung 45 and 35 ba ay divisible na sa 10? So, hindi pa. Therefore, kunin natin yung next step, which is ipa-factor natin yung ating 10. So, that is 5 times 2. So, pipili tayo ng factor dito na divisible yung 45 and 35. So, ang ating factor na divisible yung 45 and 35 ay 5. Therefore, ang GCF natin dito ay 5. So, divide natin again, numerator and denominator by 5. 35 divided by 5, 7. 45 divided by 5, 9. So, therefore, the simplified form of 35 over 45 is 7 over 9. And number 5, 20 over 50. So, the same process, divisible by 50 sa 20. Hindi. So, gawin natin yung next step, which is subtraction. 50 minus 20, we have 30. Then, yung 50 and 20 ba, divisible by 30. Hindi rin. So, kunin natin ulit yung factor ng 30. So, that is 10 times 3. Ipili tayo ng factor na divisible yung 50 and 20. So, in this case, ang factor na divisible yung 50 and 20 ay yung 10. Therefore, the GCF is 10. So, divide natin yung both numerator and denominator by 10. So, we have 20 divided by 10, that is 2. 50 divided by 10, that is 5. So, that is 2 over 5. Or kung makakita tayo ng gantong given na zeros yung end ng mga numerator and denominator natin, pwede natin i-cancel yung zeros. Then, yung matitira, that is the fraction. Kung pwede pang i-simplify, i-simplify natin. So, I hope natuto kayo sa ating video on how to simplify or reduce the fraction in lowest term. Thank you for watching and see you on our next upload. God bless everyone.